instrumental supergroup Sterling EQ has taken the South African entertainment industry by storm with their genre-defying musical style and sensational live performance. The members' obvious talent and energy and their interesting backgrounds continues to fascinate and charm the public, and has, together with the release of Nova, the movie, cemented this group's reputation as one of the top acts from South Africa.
Sterling is definitely a very special group.
A group like Sterling, for me, is really a dream come true. It's glamorous and it's exciting and it's fun.
I mean, essentially what we do is we're giving a show.
You know, playing a classical instrument and playing the flute, you don't really get that opportunity a lot. And Sterling has opened up this world for us.
I was very fortunate as a child to be encouraged to do music. Some other little Asian girls see it as a cultural curse to have to do piano, have to do violin, have to do ballet, have to do art. But I took it in my stride since I was a young child.
Always wanted to perform, and I've always known that's really what I should be doing. And in this ensemble, I can do that.
Defining Sterling's style is a task not even the members dare attempt. Their music is inspired by many different genres from various eras.
I always say, look, it's instrumental music. There's a lot of classical influence, and we draw on a lot of classical references, but it's certainly not classical by any means. We have a lot of jazz influences as well. We play Latin music and disco, originals. I always like saying we do anything from Mozart to Mendoza, which is the truth. We're actually doing a couple of Mendoza songs. It's not often that four girls just click and get along in a band like this, and we are so lucky that we just do. The concept of the music video was to sort of portray us in strong female roles, and at this point in our sort of development as a band, this is a really great image that we want to put out there. We want to show ourselves, rather than kind of objectifying ourselves, we want to put ourselves out there as strong and kind of in control. And also there's this really great element of fun throughout the music video, which truly depicts the spirit of our band and who we are as a team.
My favorite scene definitely was doing Marilyn Monroe.
I think the most I enjoyed about shooting the music video was definitely playing the part of Audrey Hepburn. She's been a childhood idol of mine from when I was very young.
We had about 10 million wigs to put on, and all the characters that we got to play, we really felt depicted us. I got to play Charlize Theron winning an Oscar, which was great fun. My favorite part was definitely Halle Berry in the James Bond movie. You know, kind of even if it's just 5 minutes of having the opportunity to be a Bond girl, I suppose that's every girl's dream.
SAMA award-winning director Laura Hollis proved her worth in gold by coming up with the concept, directing the filming, and bringing it all to life through an arduous post-production process.
For her, it was actually 2 months of post-production. I think she did an absolutely amazing job with that.
A self-released, self-made band, Sterling EQ will keep testing the boundaries as long as the audience is listening.
When we perform for big audiences, the way the audience reacts to your music, the way they clap, the way they smile, is the biggest reward I think any performer or any band can be rewarded with.
Why is it so difficult?